hope you are all doing well. My name is Irfan, and today I will start a new lecture about the ANN model using R programming to run ANN model with the help of neuralnet package. What will be my course content? So this is the ANN neuralnet package, and these are my course outlines. The first one is the introduction to ANN, then neuralnet package that will be used in R programming for ANN model, then what type of data and which type of data can be used to run the ANN model, and how can we set the data, and the one step that will be needed for ANN is the data normalization. Then we will create the ANN model with the help of the available data, and then we validate the data by drawing the confusion matrix, and then the conversion of the normalized values into actual values. So the normalization means the conversion of the actual values and to in the range of 0 and 1. So if we convert the values in a range of 0 and 1, so then we in the last step we convert the normalized values into the actual values. This is basically the ANN model. So you can see this is the just an example neural net package. The ANN model contain three type of layers. The first one is the input layer, the second one is the hidden layers, and the third one is the output layers. So the input layer means that the input variable that you have, let's suppose I have the data, this is my data set. The first one is the water intake, total rainfall, temperature, total operation. So these all four values are my input values. The output is blue water front. So this is my output. You can set the data setting means you can keep all the variable in one sheet. Suppose these all four variables are my input, and this is my output variable. So this is must that you must keep all the variables in one sheet. The last variable must be your output. This is just a data setting, and you can see the values. This is in 5000, this is in 5000, this is in 26, this is 0, this is 1.5. so on the basis of these input variables I will find out the output variable by loading my data. I will normalize these values. Normalize means I will range these values in a 0 and 1 range. So data normalization basically will be done using two steps. The first one is the scale steps, and the second one is the normalization formula, the use of normalization formula. So if you scale data by running this code, your data will be normalized. Or you can do just using this formula, and your data will be normal. Okay. This basic by running the ANN model, we will the whole data will be converted into two parts. The 80% of this data sets is called the train set, and 20% of the remaining this data will be the test data set. You can see, let's suppose I have 200 values, and up to 160 values is my train set and the train data set, and from 160 to 200 the remaining values will be my test set. And why we create these two data sets? Because we want to train the data to test the behavior of all the input values, and on the basis of these behavior of the data, and we want to predict the remaining 20% data. And in the same manner, we will create a model, and then the model will be validated using confusion matrix. Then the number of hidden layers. So this is the hidden layers means the 2-1 means you can see the hidden layers will be 2 and 1. So this is the trial base. If this error goes minimum and minimum, so hidden layer, let's suppose 2-2, and the error is minimum, so we will select that hidden layer. If the minimum error value is comes on 3-1, so we will select the hidden layers on 3-1. So this is basically the trial based error method. The hidden layer will be selected using the trial based error. Then we want install the neural net package. The name is neural net, and using these type of code. The next one is the confusion matrix. So confusion matrix means the actual values that I have and the predicted values. So this is basically the confusion matrix 0 0 1 1. So zero means false and 1 means true. So 0 0 means false values is 17, and 1 1 means the true value is 20. So if you want to find out the accuracy rate, so you must count these values. So 20 plus 17 is 37. The total value is 40. So 37 by 40 is almost 92.5% accuracy rate. So if this accuracy rate is minimum, so you will repeat the process and find out the confusion matrix and find the accuracy rate. If the accuracy is maximum, the model will be your best suited model. So let's start. The first step is to upload my data. Here is my data. This is my data. I will import the data. And the next step is attach the data. BWF is basically the name of my data. So the data has been attached. Next, I want to normalize my data. So I just copy and paste to, okay, scale data is equal to, this is just a variable, you can give any name to it. Data B is just is the my data name. Then you can, okay, I just copy the data. Okay, then normalize means to, you can give it any name, normalize, then function, this, then data, then return data minus minimum data, maximum data minus minimum data. So this is basically the formula of normalization. When I click on OK, so the data will be normalized. You can see your normalized data function. Okay, you can see, okay, okay, maximum, you can run this code. Maximum minimum df, this is just a name, you can give any name as a data frame. L apply, BWF is my data, and normalize that I stored before. So when I click enter, maximum minimum df is the data that, so you can see this is my normalized data. Say the water intake, which is between 0 and 1, total rainfall, temperature, total operation, BWF and data. Then the next step is then I want to create the two data sets within my this data set. The first one is 80% of my data will be the trained data. You can take it 70% also. Then remaining 20% of my data is test data. So if you can see the data set, this is all 1097 means 1096 data. So if you take the 80% of this will be almost 87. So the train set is equal to maximum minimum df that I stored before, so the normalized data set, and I want to take only 80% of my data, which is 870 up to 870 serial number. So this is the train data set. Then the test data, test set, you can give any name to it. Maximum minimum df is equal to the maximum minimum df is basically the data name, normalized data set. at 71 to 10, this is the test data. Then the next step, the train set is 80% of your data, normalized data, and the test data is 20%, remaining 20% of your data. The next step is you must install the neural net package. If you have the already installed the neural package, so you just want library. If not, so install it and just neural net and just enter. Is I already installed, so I will type the library and find the neural net package there. It's not running, so it means that your installation is not completed. The next is I already type here. So the next step is double A is just a variable name. You can type any variable. So the neural net, then the input data here, you can just look at. This is basically the BWF data, is basically this is my output data versus the input values. So if you can see, there are four variables that I considered as an input variable, and this is my output variable. So the output variable, you just type the output variable here versus input plus input. So if you have four or five or six variables or one variable, you just type there and with a plus sign. Then data that I used is the train data, that is 80% of my data. Then hidden layers, I want to create the hidden layer is 2:1, so you can change it 2:2, 2:2, 3:1, 3:2, etc. and find the confusion matrix. If the accuracy is more, so on which hidden layer the accuracy is more, so you will select that hidden layer. I tried many times and found that the 2:1 hidden layer is the maximum, give me the maximum accuracy, so I select this accuracy rate. Next one is result matrix. I want to find out the result matrix, which is this. The error is 3.04 and 10 to power minus 1, and steps involved, the steps completed is 3.6. Okay, then the next step is plot ANN model. Just plot, and A is the variable name that you stored before, and you can see your ANN model. These are the input variable, the hidden layer 2:1, and the output variable. The next step is to find out the confusion matrix. So this is my variable temperature test. Is just a variable name subset. Then the test data, we select two data set, the train data and test data, and here we select only the input variable, without output variable, that is the water intake, total rainfall, temperature and total evaporation. Here no output variable will be typed. Now I want to find out the head of my data. So the head of my data is water intake, total rainfall, temperature and total evaporation, and these will be the this is just as an example. You can select any, which is the 20th number, and then compute your test data results, data frame, the actual data, test data versus the output variable, then prediction of the data. You can select it, the results, find out the results. These are the remaining 20% data. The data set is the actual data. The 20% of my data is only for the output is this value. These values are my the actual values, which is from 871. You can also check it. 872 from 871 to 10 is my the test data, which is 20% of my data. So the actual value of the output variable, this output variable is and the predicted which the prediction which is done using the ANN model is 0.8. so this means that the actual and predicted value is very much near So the prediction is very good. Now I want to find out the confusion matrix, the validation of this model. So the next step will be rounded results as applied as the variable that I stored here as the actual and predicted values. Round means to round this figure up to two or three digit. So here I type zero, so it means zero digit. Then these are just rounded results df as just a variable name, then attach rounded results, then table of actual versus prediction. So this is my confusion matrix. The total values is almost 20% of my data is almost 96 minus 871 become 225 values. So you can see the 225, the total is 225 values plus 7 10 0, 3.